Hi, everybody. Welcome to Behind the Scenes of Diary of a Wimpy Alien 6, Cabin Slaughter.
The idea for this one, it came from a number of different places. We knew we were already kind of building up trying to reference as many different horror icons as possible in this parody series. One of the things that inspired putting Jigsaw in this one was we knew the location that we really wanted to film in.
We have this wonderful contact, Lockbuster's Escape Room, which is a awesome escape game attraction in Orlando off of International Drive. I gave him a call and said, hey, we have this video that we're doing and we would love to shoot in your collector room, which is their serial killer room. The owner was all about it and it was amazing to shoot there because it's a full set ready to go and we couldn't have constructed or made anything better and I didn't have to hurt anybody's feelings and saying, hey, you have the grossest basement, that's what we want to use.
But of course, one of the most important things I think, and in general we think, is trying to make sure that not only are we parodying whatever the new thing is, Saw,
actually having to exact that violence. Go on.
We want to make sure we're, you know, always paying homage to Alien and Predator. They have to be true to their characters. But it's not really a good Wimpy Kid parody unless you're parodying a Wimpy Kid plot. This is the first time that we've done one that's purely book-based. And it was Brendan's idea to include Chucky as well as Jigsaw. I admit I hemmed and hawed for just a moment, but as soon as he mentioned the idea that maybe Chucky's Roderick's baby practice doll, since we already had Greg's, that's all instant. I was like, okay, I'm on board with this completely. That's a great second line. Oh, that's my baby practice doll.
It's my old baby practice doll.
Hey kids, wanna play?
I love Chucky. Love, love, love Chucky. So when I found out that Chucky and Jigsaw were going to be in this episode, I'm like, wow, that sounds awesome.
So early on the list, one of the first things we knew we needed to find was a good Chucky doll, and I think that same evening I bumped into one almost immediately at my friend Caitlin's house, and her Aunt Gina puts on these amazing Halloween haunted houses every year, and her and all her sisters and cousins all come and help and put them all together, and they always have just an insane collection of Halloween props. We've actually used some of them before. I think some of the severed body parts all over the house after the party aftermath of In Dire Wobillion 2.
It was crazy to play with toys for a large part of the video and have that play such a pivotal role, especially in the action sequences. And surprisingly, the most difficult thing to shoot in this entire video was actually Chucky and the facehugger battling each other out. Like, literally every time we try to get a shot of them colliding, Chucky would drop his knife or the facehugger would look kind of silly. So this was our first time working with Louie, and Louie is awesome. He's a major team player, and nowhere is that more apparent than when he played Chucky for some of the shots where we needed not a doll necessarily, but we actually needed somebody in the Chucky costume running around and stuff. When we were kind of envisioning the sequence of Chucky and Predator facing each other off, I thought it would be really fun to cut from shots of Chucky the doll in the foreground moving side to side. And then we'd get an aerial shot where I'd be on top of a ladder angled down with somebody in the Chucky costume running back and forth. I thought that'd be a kind of a fun way to shoot the sequence.
Surprise! Yes, I was Jigsaw. I really loved playing this character. I've asked Will, I'm like, if we could write him back in, I would play him in a heartbeat. I love a movement. I'm a movement-based actor, so all of my characters, I begin with their movement, so it kind of starts from the outside in, and the fact that I got to play a doll that was brought to life was a lot of fun. So, you know, it's not super realistic, but you know, you have these kind of staccato movements but also trying to emote as well.
Olea is just a mastermind of doing these mascot-type characters. It seems like a thankless task being behind all these masks, but I think she puts into it something that just the average actor doesn't necessarily bring to the table. A lot of her physicality, a lot of comedy through little slight reactions and moves. I think Jigsaw is one of the ones, because Greg is very large in life. Watch Jigsaw's emotions. He's a little more subtle.
We took this mask, which was one piece, and we got it at a Halloween store because we filmed it around Halloween, but we wanted the mouth to move. So we actually just cut this piece off and we took spirit gum and put that to my chin right there. So we had the ability to move the mouth with using this mask.
So with this Wimpy Alien, it was really cool to see a lot of masked characters, the Predator, Greg the Alien, and Manny all sitting at a table at the same time in the same shot. We've never done that before. Most of the time we try to limit the number of masked characters on screen because it's so hard to shoot with them. It's been said many times, actors that are playing any of those characters are practically blind in these masks. It's kind of creeping your way through a scene, walking through where certain characters need to look, their eye line, because sometimes they think they're looking in the right place and they're actually looking here or here and not exactly where I want them to look. It's almost like we stepped onto a set of a sitcom, a really messed up sitcom, starring Predator Alien and Pred-Alien. I look forward to upping the ante with more masked characters in the future.
So we have really fallen in love with Diary of a Wimpy Alien, and we want to continue to do more. If you'd like to help us out, if you like what we do and want to give us $1 or $5 or even more, that'd be great. You can visit us on patreon.com/andyoufilms, and all of your money goes directly into funding each and every parody video. So any help would be greatly appreciated and would go right back into the products that you know and love.